I knew that I kind of wanted to keep all the tones fairly neutral, at least in the house. Everything has a very specific color tone, and there's like one or two colors in each scene, and that comes from production design and costumes and all of that, and lighting. But then as soon as she leaves, she has less control over her world as she goes into the outside world, so colors start to mix, then we bring in some greens and warmer colors, and you know, and like pink neon lighting in the motel. And then eventually when she gets to the mall, it's a whole cluster of colors. It's kind of like chaotic in a way. I feel like I tend to lean to, even in, you know, a day exterior, it's rare that I shoot 5600. I'll usually shoot 43 or something. It's hard for me to look at something that has like a pure white light, or so I always sort of mix it up or to do the opposite and go to like 8000 or something. But with this, I really wanted to try to keep it as clean as possible. And when you do that, you're just strictly looking at how you light it. So we shot with the AMIRA because budgetary reasons, but we did do some handheld, and I so much more prefer the AMIRA than the Mini or even the XT or something. It's just, it fits so well on your shoulder. And especially for the kind of, you know, when you do commercial work, sometimes an easy rig is nice, and it's, you're wearing the camera for so long and you want to get weird, interesting angles. But I really prefer to operate on my shoulder when I do narrative, because I feel like I want to be closer with the actor, and it's just more intuitive, and it just ergonomically feels right. But we shot with the Master Primes, and we tested lenses, because another thing that me and Carlo talked about was perhaps for these close-ups of these objects, maybe shooting the whole film on the Master Primes, because I knew that I wanted to have it sort of perfect and clean and sharper. And I've never shot a film with the Master Primes before, and I kind of really fell in love with how they look. I like that there's not too much fall off, that you can still feel connected with the subject and their surroundings, and that's really important, especially in this film. But then for the close-ups, I was thinking maybe we could shoot with vintage lenses, so there's some sort of something special about it. Maybe they're, you know, the highlights have a little bloominess or something. But when we did the testing, it was really important to actually have more detail. So the sharper, you know, 100 mil with a diopter was actually so much more important, because that's when you get all of the detail and the texture in all those objects. So we ended up just shooting everything with the Master Primes. I had my DIT build a lot. Yeah, I was a little concerned with using such sharp glass, that it's slightly higher contrast glass, and being in a house for most of this location where if it was sunny outside in the middle of the day and we were shooting inside looking towards the windows, we didn't have enough lighting to push the same amount of light through the window. So I was concerned with the high contrast situation, how that would be. So we worked on a LUT that, you know, lowered the contrast a little bit, softened the highlights, things like that, and it ended up just working so beautifully. This stuff, like, pretty much stuck to that sort of look for the grade as well. I mess around with the ASA in a way that is not really intentional. It's just that I like to work fast, and I'm very specific about my f-stop and everything. So always changes. I don't shoot with one f-stop. It depends on the lens. You know, sometimes you need to close down so you get a little more depth of field. So sometimes it's easier to jump down one or two notches in ISO to get right where I need to be. So I just jump around quite a bit, and I don't normally go above 1600, but I know some people shoot strictly, you know, 800 or something and just use filtration, but sometimes you need less than a stop, so you can't use an ND all the time. So yeah, it's a lot of like ACs that haven't worked with me before always question that and wonder if there's some reason behind it. Or I'll post a photo of the monitor on Instagram and people are like, why are you shooting it 640? And like, think there's some crazy reason to it, but it's not really.